Hello fans, today we're gonna look at and test this quadcopter from Lightake. You can buy it at lightake.com. This is the San Juan SH5 standard quadcopter. And here we have this QR code for Apple and Android for the camera. Okay. Let's open. First, this is a manual. English and Chinese. I'm not so good at Chinese yet. It says about how to steer this quadcopter, how to charge, and you can see this map over the parts, the article codes, so you can order parts when you crash. Everyone crash. Yeah. It's a good packing, so no damage on the models. That's important. So. Landing gear, you have to mount them and attach the screw. Prop savers. This attachment for your phone. And you have this USB charger, one cell sleep battery. You have this camera. It's out to megapixels. Okay, with the antenna. There we have spare propellers. A screwdriver. Okay, a transmitter. This is a standard transmitter. Oh, this is just fake. This is not the real buttons. There we have this. You can change the rate, how fast you want the quadcopter to react on your stick movements. I think three modes. And here you have this flip. So it's like other quadcopters. Flip around, change the rate. Throttle and roll forward, backward. Yeah. And trim buttons, and this is for taking pictures or activating the camera. So that's all, and you need 4 AA batteries. You need to buy them, it's not in the package. So here we have the quadcopter, same plastic as other cheap quadcopters. Seems okay. Lights under. Okay, we have this hatch. I think it's there's the battery. So it's one cell sleep-o, 650 milliamps. Let's charge them. First, I'm gonna connect this this camera, the quadcopter, like this. Under you can see a little on-off switch for the quad. And I just slide the camera in place, like this. So I have to mount this. I never use these protections. You can do it, but I never do. Maybe it's smart if you hit your head or something, or finger. So we have this small four legs for landing gear, and you have this. I can use this now. And then you have to secure the landing gear with these screws. Yeah. So now we are ready to install the application for the FV mode. So I use my QR scanner and scan this Google Play. Like this. Then Air to Play application. Then we need to turn on the quadcopter to receive a Wi-Fi signal. It's like this, like other apps for this quadcopter. And here we have this. So we have to connect, turn on the quadcopter first. Perfect for my LG7 phone. Yeah. It's a little loose. The phone may fall off. So you have to make sure your phone is attached. Yeah. Now you can fly cheap FPV. Turn on the transmitter and I always place my finger on top. Full throttle and back. Then we are ready to fly. We can change the rates. One press is one, is very slow on the stick movements. I like to use mode 2. Okay, back to the Wi-Fi. Gonna search for signal. Okay, we have build win. I think it's that. Okay, it's connected. Let's try the application. Air to play. Will it work? Yeah, perfect. This is my living room. Now I will try to fly FPV. In mode 2 the quadcopter is quite fast. Great that it worked instantly. I don't think the quadcopter will handle the wind because it's very light. But it's reacting very great on my movement. You can see. It's a very cheap quadcopter, so you get, I think, great value for your money to try FPV. Camera has only 2 megapixels. Yeah. So, let's see how fast this can fly indoors. Seems great. Very easy to fly this. Every quadcopter now, cheap or expensive, are, I think they are impressively great to fly. Yes! It's going also to test the video quality. Yeah, you have to record with your phone. And lens tilt is this. You have to do it manual, like this. I'm gonna try it like this, I think. Then you have to record. I think you can take pictures there. Take pictures there, and you can start to record there. Yes.